First, I'd like to take a quick look at the Odyssey, for which the game is named. It's the ship that Mario uses to travel the world, and it's powered by these power moons, so you keep needing additional thresholds of them to get onto the next kingdom. And just to show off a little bit of the new moves, obviously there's the hat throw. You can make it stay in place, which is sometimes valuable. It can grab things for you. There's two kinds of coins, which we'll talk about a little later on.
Actually, there in that little dialogue box, we saw Cappy.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Cappy is both the red hat that he's wearing and also in his native form, he's a white top hat. And so one other move that's pretty cool is this circular throw. Knocks away everything. But let's get down into the city. And as you saw in the trailer, so there's the capture mechanic lets you take over things. It also lets you do fairly exotic things like turn into electricity, travel through wires. So how did the capture mechanic come about?
So when we were making this game, what we started out doing was making just a huge amount of different gameplay prototypes. And this capture action was just one of those prototypes.
みんなでこうアイデアを出し合った中に出てきたんですけども、それをそうですね、2、3日ぐらいで作って遊んでみたらものすごく面白かったので、すぐゲームの中心に入れようと決めました。
So, you know, it was just one of the ideas that came up, but we worked on it for 2 or 3 days, and it just instantly turned into something that was really fun, and we decided, well, okay, this should just be the center of this game.
I love how much it encourages that exploration and experimentation that I think the Mario games along these lines are so known for when you think about Super Mario 64, Super Mario Sunshine. Here we've got so much stuff that just looks interesting, and you're wondering, okay, what will happen if I throw my cap at it? You never really know what's going to happen, so you want to try everything just to see.
何でも試してみたくなる仕様ですね。どういう要素があるの?そうですね。いろんな物に帽子を投げたり、試してもらえたらなと思ってます。
Yeah, I definitely hope when people, while they're playing this game, they just throw their hat at everything and try all sorts of different things.
That was a mistake. Right now, normally, if you were following the story path of the game, you'd be talking to Mayor Pauline, who wants you to recruit musicians. There's one there. But we're going to ignore that right now because there's lots and lots of things to do beyond following the main story of the game. Like possess rockets and turn into rockets
and why
with mustaches.
You do that if you could? Actually, that's an interesting note there. So you mentioned Mayor Pauline, and I think our sharp-eyed viewers will have noticed that some of the street signs are references to some Donkey Kong characters. We've got some interesting red girders going on here. I wonder, Kozuma-san and Wanakura-san, if you can tell us a little bit more about this city. It's got some interesting backstory.
やっぱりポリンシチョがいて、ニュードンシティという名前がついてると、何かこの都市について説明していただけますか。そうですね。名前もそうですし、ポリンってドンキーコングのキャラクターで、何かのゲームに関係がありそうですけど、今日はちょっとあまり詳しく言えないんですけど。
So certainly you can tell that Pauline is from Donkey Kong, and the name New Donk City probably leads you to a couple of hints, but we can't get into too much of it today.
And I like the shirt you're wearing, by the way.
That is a snazzy
good choice
shirt.
Today.
お楽しみに.
Please look forward to hearing more about that.
I gotta take the long way.
Oh, good luck. And this is interesting here where we see, I mean, really throughout New Donk City, and I think throughout the world, we've got these really fun playground elements where you're bouncing on things, you're jumping on things, you're swinging. Can you tell our viewers a little bit more about how you came up with that kind of play mechanic in the game?
ぶら下がってして、飛び跳ねたりして、いろんな環境のものに反応させられるんですけど、どういうふうに、そういう遊び場っぽい雰囲気を出せるように考え方ありますか？はい。まずその試作っていうので、ものすごくいっぱい遊びを作っています。それをこう配置して、ステージっていうものを作ります、まず。
So, you know, going back to that prototyping process I was talking about before, we obviously create lots and lots of different ones, lots and lots of different game ideas. And then next, what we think about is where to place them within the stage.
そこにそのアートであるとか具体的なものを乗せて遊んでみます。
So, you know, we put it in the stage, we like combine it with different art assets, like kind of like real things to see what it might actually look like or work in game, and then try playing it.
そうすると、もっとこうしたいとか、いろんな意見が出てくるので、それをさらにそこに上乗せして作っています。
And then, you know, obviously out of that, like, different things come up, like, oh, maybe we could do this a little bit differently. Maybe this could actually work like this instead. And then we kind of add that to it, and the process just continues from there.
なので先ほどちょっと出たあのタクシーなんかをジャンプさせるのもあのスーパーマリオサンシャインでもちょっと似たような仕様があったのでそういうところからちょっとヒントを得ている、います。
Mm. And so, you know, you saw before, you know, we were able to jump on top of the taxi, and that's something that was sort of in Super Mario Sunshine at times, so in that way we're also getting hints from past games.
Can I quickly interject that As I mentioned, the goal right now is to recruit these musicians. When I was first playing this game for a feedback report for the development team, I could not figure out how to get to this guy on the top of this building. You can just barely see him. He's a speck right now in that triangular building. And the way I eventually found to do it was to take a really long fall.
I did that too.
And yeah. That worked.
Oh, I put my first knees.
A bit to my surprise. And I wanted to know, you know, when you saw that report from me, you know, what was that a problem to be solved? Was that a cool thing? What was that?
コマネはあの NCR の報告書を書いていた時に、まあ、こういうふうにあのトランペットのバンドの真似を到着できますよと書いてましたが、それはそれを見てちょっと困っていったんでしょうか。
はい、あのそれは読んだんですけれども、あの読んだんですけれども。今日ここでプレイするとは思わなかったです。
Yeah, I did read that. I didn't know you were going to be playing that right now.
Troublemaker.
でもこう、
well, I also know the real way. I'm just, I'm, or another way.
まあ本当、本当のやり方も分かってます。
でも自分でこういろんなプレイの仕方を探してもらえたらと思うんですけども、それもスーパーマリオ64やスーパーマリオサンシャインから続くものだと思います。
But you know, you found your own way to play it, and like you know, letting users you know play around with the game and find their own ways of doing things. That's something that you know goes way back in 3D Mario, you know, in Super Mario 64 and Super Mario Sunshine as well.
So this is actually one of the two kingdoms that's going to be playable on the show floor. The show floor, of course, isn't open yet, so we don't have folks playing the game at this moment. But I'm really looking forward to talking to folks after they played it, because I think there's so many different ways to problem solve and find the moons in these kingdoms.I'm not even sure if folks will find everything over the course of the show, but it's going to be interesting to find out how different people approached completing some of these objectives.
But the game encourages so much experimentation because you aren't kicked out of the level every time you find a moon. There is no reason not to investigate every little thing you can see that might be interesting. There's no time limit, there's no disincentive. There's lots and lots of cool stuff. Whoa, okay.
Yeah, that is a very interesting change that adds, I think, to the immersion in the kingdoms. When you think about Super Mario 64, Super Mario Sunshine, whenever you got your, so whatever the collectible objective was, depending on the game you were playing, you'd get bumped out of the area and you'd have to come back in. But here, since you're not going to get booted out of the kingdom when you collect a power moon, there's a lot of encouragement to just go check out that weird thing you saw on the horizon, because you can still continue with whatever your primary objective is.
No.
But then, you know, keep on trekking and finding moons.
Another reason to explore everything is that there's very little punishment for dying. I just lost 10 coins, and you know, there's lots. So, and I get to try again right away.
Mr. Bito, 10 coins to buy this thing.
Oh, look at that.
It's also worth mentioning that the Bullet Bills here are coming out with visors on, so they cannot be captured until you knock their hats off, because an enemy with a hat is the scariest thing in this game.
Fashion is very important in this game. You gotta be conscious of your headwear.
Oh, no. Well, apparently this is not my day for this challenge.
That's right, third time's a charm, right?
Yeah. And if at first you don't succeed, give up on the third attempt.
I'm just looking at the space where we saw other sections of New Dog City, and looking here, I'm just so impressed with the texture work that's been done. And I feel like every time I see a new build of this game, more and more of these textures are just jumping out at me. It's really fun to see in person.
It is a gorgeous game, and we have some other segments later on in the stream that are going to highlight some especially pretty areas.
Oh, you got this.
Yeah.
And while I'm keeping my fingers and toes crossed, yes.
Thank you.
One thing that we haven't mentioned yet that we probably should talk a little bit about is the fact that you're playing with Joy-Con with the wrist straps attached.
Yes.
And that's a really fantastic way to play this game. It, of course, supports Pro Controller and other controller options, but you can do so much with the motion controls, and throwing Cappy feels very intuitive.
Yeah. I'm going to switch to a different section of the game where I show the Sand World, which is also playable on the show floor. So give me just a moment
here. Oh, no worries. But I do love that as you're experimenting, and I think we'll see folks doing that on the show floor here, so many of your gestures will affect how Cappy moves, that while you're holding the Joy-Con with the wrist straps attached, you really want to just try moving your arms in different directions. Like, okay, I'm going to try throwing up, I'm going to throw down, throw out. But I was really impressed by how well that implementation was put into play. Here we are.
Yeah.
Oh, this place is so pretty.
So here we are in the Sand Kingdom, in the town of Tostarena. And they had a problem now because it's all frozen. Everything is cold for reasons, of course, that Mario will eventually solve.
Yeah, actually, if you hang still for a second, we can show his little idle animation when he's
cold.
Oh,
yeah, yeah, yeah.
Really cute.
Oh, he's cold.
I love the locals here, too.
Yeah, I think he's distracted by the local dancing around, but I think if he's by himself, then he really shivers.
Oh, poor Mario.
Yeah. So let's see here. One thing I did want to show off is, so as we mentioned, there's two kinds of coins in this game. And for the, I believe the first time in the mainline Mario series, you can actually buy things with your coins. And I wanted to ask the developers how that came up, you know, that currency should be worth currency.
なんでコインで買い物できるようにしたいと思ったんでしょうか。
はい、今回はコインを本当にお金として扱おうと思いました。
So we wanted, you know, coins to be used as coins in this game, actually use them as money.
外国に行った時にその国のお金ってすごいなんか印象に残ってないですか。
And you know, I think you'll agree, you know, if you go to, you know, a foreign land, one of the things that makes the biggest impression on you is the currency.
これ使えるのとか思ったりしないですか。
You know, you kind of look at it and you think, wait, is this real? Can I use this?
今回はマリオもいろんな国を旅しますので、その国その国のコインというものを用意しています。
And since, you know, Mario is going around to all these different kingdoms in this game, we wanted to make sure that there was a currency for each one.
要素はコレクトするコインの要素になっていますので、集めたものでコスチュームを変えたり、お土産を買うことができます。
And you know, they're collectible items, so you can use them to buy different outfits or buy souvenirs.
Speaking of,
yeah, and it's always fun to buy souvenirs, right?
Yeah,
absolutely. And speaking of shopping, we are now in Crazy Cap.
So there's two kinds of coins, as we mentioned. The purple ones are unique to the local kingdom. The yellow ones are can be used in any shop. I'm going to buy. Because the guy at the door said, I'm not living up to their dress code, maybe I should buy some clothes to fit in better. I'm going to buy a local sombrero and poncho. And wait till you see how adorable Mario looks.
Being adorable, I just love the shopkeeper.
Yeah, and their huge stack of hats.
He's so cute.
And you can see some of the souvenirs you can buy there that you can use to decorate the inside of the ship.
Nice.
And now I'm rocking this look. And let's go try that door again. So my capabilities are the same. You know, I still have, it's still Cappy, even though he's turned into a different kind of hat now. He can turn into any kind of headwear, apparently. Exotic superpower. And all right, so I go over and talk to this guy.
Let's see if you meet the expectations now. Ooh, snappy and lively.
Snappy and lively. I think the hat is the one and the poncho is the other. All right. And this is, of course, what the goal I was working toward all this time.
I love all these little moments of surprise where you never really know what's going to happen when you
Why did I want to get in
spaces.
This room? I don't know. I wanted to get in this room so I could play a guitar.
You want to get in because it's locked.
Yeah, exactly. So then we're going to move on to some more traditional 3D Mario gameplay over this direction.
Now that you are terribly well-dressed, it's time to go do some exploring.
Yeah. And Bowser's footprints, I must be on the right track. So notice that by using the motion controls, I can actually use the little homing function on the hat more easily. It is possible with the button controls only, but it's much more difficult.
All right, the classic Goomba.
Yeah. And let's just do a big one for that. And yeah.
And that's, I guess, something folks are probably noticing here. So you're not capturing those Goomba. It's not every single enemy that's capturable.
That's true.
You've got to find the special ones.
Yeah.
And a lot of it's having a good eye and just experimenting a lot with your cap.
I think they're a shade bigger, the ones you can capture, but I'm not positive about that.
Nice.
So bullet bills, of course, are useful because you can fly with them. And now I've got to very quickly capture my ride back.
And with bullet bills, you can only capture them for a limited amount of time because at some point they're just going to blow up.
Yeah.
So you have to be a little mindful of what you're doing.
Yeah, you only get so much time with the explosive guys. All right, and then almost to one of my favorite bits in this level.
Oh yeah, the next bit you're coming up to.
Yeah.
Blew my mind the first time I saw it.
So this place has these murals that look like they're decorated in this cool old school aesthetic, and I'm just gonna go right on in. And I've still got my costume.
So Koizumi-san and Motokura-san, I think we definitely need to hear a little bit more background about why you added this into the game, because it's so cool, but it's so unexpected as well, I think.
なんでこのような 2D の 8-bit マリオのところも入れたいと思ったんでしょうか。
3D の部分は気持ちよく探索できるように比較的おおらかに作っています。
So we wanted to make something that would be, you know, sort of a contrast with the 3D stages that you're able to explore very freely.
2D の部分はもう少し細かく緊張感のある構成になっています。
You know, the 2D spaces are kind of more confined. They're more precise. You know, it's more like kind of you know, sort of traditional platforming elements.
同じステージの中でもそういった違った遊びっていうのを入れたかったです。
And but also within the 2D stages, as you can see, we wanted to have a lot of different variety.
もちろんこう昔からのゲームが好きな人にも楽しんでもらえるビジュアルになってると思います。
And of course, you know, with the visuals, we're hoping it's something, you know, the people who enjoyed kind of those classic nostalgic games also get a kick out of as well.
So one thing I'd love to show off when we're getting out toward the end of this space is just how much the music changes when we're transitioning back and forth. Because I know we've been chatting, maybe it's hard for some folks to hear what's been going on here, but if we just pop in and out of that warp pipe, it's a pretty impressive transition when the music changes.
But there's no warp pipe up here.
Just sort of jump off.
No, but you can now see that it's more of a naturalistic instrument. So I'm going to skip ahead and show off the last part of this scenario. Okay, so for that, I will need these. Wrist straps, people, always wrist straps.
Yes. All set to jump in.
Okay.
Yeah, it's worth mentioning, too, that we're only covering a tiny bit of what is in this kingdom. There's so much more to do and explore.
There's just a ridiculous amount. All right, so here we are. This is much later in the level. I've still got my snappy outfit, though. And watch these bullet bills transition out of the 2D. And then I'm going to use one to break open this wall.
So another thing that's really handy about the bullet bills as a capture target that you'll see here, when you're trying to target for really precision flying, it's got a little bit of a headlamp.
I'm doomed.
That's okay. But it's got a little bit of a headlamp, so you can kind of use that to line yourself up.
Ooh, it's super handy.
That's okay, because we get to see this cute little 2D to 3D transitioning
in
with the bills.
It's so cool. All right.
All right, you got this.
All right, here we go.
And with the bullet bills, you can also give yourself little speed bursts as well. Shaking the Joy-Con will let you go a little bit further. So it's worth experimenting once you get a feel for the timing of how long a bullet bill will last.
It's kind of like driving a car that doesn't have any brake pedal. You can go faster, you can steer, but that's all you can do. And all right, so up here we're about to confront one of the Brutals. And folks may have seen them in our original teaser trailer for this game. They are an evil wedding planning firm, and I'd love to hear more from the developers about how they came to be and what your favorite Brutal is.
ブライダルという団体がこの結婚を企画しているグループらしいですけど、はい、一番気に入りのブライダルさんは誰かいますか。
そうですね、彼らはクッパに、雇われてクッパの結婚式を成功させようとしています。
So they've, you know, as you kind of said, they've been employed by Bowser. They're in charge of making sure his wedding goes off without a hitch. They're very serious about their work.
Their work ethic is admirable.
なので、あの、真ん中にいるちょっと背の低い同じような帽子をかぶったようなキャラクターがいるんですけれども、それがリーダーなので僕はそのトッパーというキャラクターがあのお気に入りです。
And you know, my favorite is Topper, the kind of shorter one who has that green top hat.
Yeah, guy in green. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, Topper.
How about you, Koizumi-san? Do you have a favorite?
Koizumi-san はクリーンのキャラ。あ、そうですね。ちょっとちょうど今出てるのがハリエットっていうその可愛いウサギさんの、キャラクターなんですけど、なんか可愛い香りしてるのに結構凶暴なんで、その。
That's really good timing because the character I like the most is the one you're fighting right now, Harriet. She has this great contrast between her cute appearance and like how devilish she is. She's sort of like the tricky little sister of the group here.
Her attacks are really fun to watch as well, especially when she starts flying around.
And it's worth mentioning, you fight each of the Brutals a few times, but their tactics get more and more intense and dangerous.
But I'll be honest, having planned a wedding last year, I would take the help of evil wedding planner.
Yeah, I mean,
monsters.
Any evil help is better than no help.
And they're very dedicated to their work.
And they're willing
they
to fight your enemies for you, and that's pretty great.
Oh, nice.
There we go.
Nicely done.
Thank you.
Oh, sorry.
Sorry, Harriet.
Now she'll be back. All right, so that's a grand moon worth 3 power moons.
And there we see Cappy in his natural state
yep,
as well.
There he is, celebrating with Mario.
Nice.
All right, so that's what we have.